and good morning. Welcome back again. Put the nets out again today. I'm going to put three nets out, flatfish nets. See if we can get some flatfish on a 31.6 foot tide today. So the tide's pretty good. The winds are in the right direction, should I say. They've just come round into the north overnight, which is that direction. Towards that way, so they tend to be coming round now from the northwest, coming into the west this afternoon. It looks very calm out there at the minute, but I've checked the weather forecast over the last few days, and even just about half an hour ago, and the wind's picking up this afternoon, which is perfectly for what we want, just to push the flatfish in. Last time I put the nets out back in winter for the cod and the flatfish, the wind should have been in the southwest, which is that direction, all day, and then decided to come round to the southeast, coming off the land, which is no good on this beach for fishing if the wind's in the southeast. So hopefully today we'll have a better day fishing. But just turn me on here now. We're on the 4 minutes past six in the morning. So tide is due to turn at 20 to 7. The low water's 9 minutes past six. So I'm just going to get the nets out now. With it being a 31 foot plus tide, the tide will come up pretty quick. So let's get these out. I say I've not put them out yet. I say because I want to show you how I put them out for those people that want to do beach stake netting. So I've got my spade, sledgehammer, got my wooden plates. They're great, them. These are the ones from last time that we saw on the other videos. Just 12mm ply. Absolutely brilliant, solid as a rock. Just when you get them home, stick them out in the sun to dry them out so they don't rot up. And I say they're used again. So cheap as houses, really. I used to use bricks, but because of don't underestimate the, because I got a trolley, it's easy to pull because it's not. So I've got all that net in there. There's two nets. You've got all the lead line in there. I've got another net in there. I've got my toolbox just in case anything goes wrong. Spade, sledgehammer, tubes. There's four tubes there. You know, they're what, good for 4 or 5 kilo each. So it's, you know, it all adds up. So it's quite difficult to pull out. So I'll just put them out for you now. I'll also just say these videos will be on in 15 minute intervals. For some strange reason, the channel won't allow me to upload anything longer than 15 minutes. So when you look at the first ones or the second ones, just have a little look. I say there'll be more on this. There'll probably be out three, and then obviously I'll put them on tonight of when I come out to clean the nets. I know last time I had to answer the phone last time, so this time I'll definitely put the cleaning of the nets on so you can see what I caught. I mean, there's one subscriber that's asked about the catch, so I'll put the catch on. I mean, I did catch stuff last time. I just obviously forgot to put it up until a later date. So let's get these nets out. I say we're not far off low water. So we've got half an hour or so to put the nets out. That should be plenty of time. And then we'll just wait for the nets to be semi-submerged. And then we'll head off the beach. Right. I'll start here. Just put that one in there. I used to use a bait pump for putting these in. The reason why I don't do it anymore is because I found that the sand goes soft around the pole and it has more chance of coming out. So what I tend to do is just put it in a little bit and then just get the sledgehammer and just hit it into the ground. So if you've got headphones on now, take them out or turn it down because it will be loud. That's soft even with just the pole in like that. There you go. That's how that one goes in. Right, now to stick the nets out. Just have a little shuffle around. This is almost like my little vessel, this. So it used to work on the trawler, so putting these nets out here the way you would on a boat, put out over the back, and you don't have to got the wrong end of the trolley then. Put it out over the back and then you don't have to worry about snagging up or out. Put that there like that. Right, so remember we want the lead line into the flood of the tide. So we're gonna be going that way. So grab the pin that way like that. Swing the trolley round. Right, so trolley's that way, we're gonna be heading up that way. So just head in a little bit. So first end out. Lead line, float line, should I say? Right, when you put your ropes round, wrap around a couple of times. If you do an immediate knot straight away, because it will pull tight anyway. If you do an immediate knot, when you come to get it off, you won't be able to get it off. So best way to do, wrap it around a few times and then go under your rope. Oh, sorry, if you can't see that, apologies. So you go under your rope, lot. Go under it and then come back round. It almost acts like a locking system, so it locks it in, but you can still be able to get it off. So around again, and then just do a few half hitches underneath, and that won't go anywhere, that. Just a few half inches. So this rope will pull tight, but that knot will still be able to come undone when you come to get your nets in. And that's good, that, so you just push it down, and that won't move. See? That's only me pulling it, but it will pull tight, but it'll only pull tight around the pole. It won't pull this knot tight because there's enough rope to stop it from pulling tight and being able to undo it. Right, like I say, this is like my little vessel now, so we'll just pull it out a bit. Yes, and then we're going to stick a plate in. In there like that. There we go. Fill that back in with the sand. So you'll think just because it's wood it'll pull it out, but it actually doesn't. If you dry the wood out, it'll do its job because it won't soft, the wood won't go soft. So same again with these. Wrap it around a couple of times. Sorry if you can't see it, you're basically looking at my crotch there. I'll show you in a second. I've wrapped it around a couple of times, just stuck it on. That won't come out now, but the net will still stay on the bottom. Right, let's pay this net out. A little pull just to tighten it up. Do it. Pull the lead line, not the head rope, because the head rope will just flap round. You want the lead line to be tight, not the head rope. For obvious reasons, yeah, look how much slack there is there. So what I was saying in the last video is the head rope will just flap around in the wind, in the water. So we'll just make sure the lead line's tight so that sits from the bottom. And if you're doing that, you'll be on a winner. So these are the flatfish ones that we had out last time. So there's one. I've left the green one at home. Wasn't too impressed with the green one. Might have to cut that one out and make another net out of it. So just some strange reason, doesn't want a fish for some bizarre reason. Hence why it's still at home in the shed. So right. That one around, we'll just pull that one tight like that. Around here, same process again. Just lead line into the flood and another post. It's not rocket science. If you do it properly, your fish are there, it'll do your job. Good job for you. So we'll leave that as it is like that because I'm more than happy with that. Right, here we go. You got headphones on. Turn it down. Bang, bang, bang. We're a bit wobbly here now. See, that's what that's like now. It's dead wobbly. Imagine what it was like if I was using my bait pump. Using my bait pump, it would just like, just move all the water around it. It would just make it like dead soft. More of a chance of the pole coming out the sand than if it decides to. Not that you do, but if you've got less friction there, it will come out. These tubes are just normal scaffold tubes, they're not anything special. Just normal scaffold tubes that you'd see at the side of a building. Nothing expensive or special metals. Right, let's have a go with this one. So you can see it. So go around once, around twice, then we'll go under to lock the rope in place. So go around twice. I've locked it in place there like that, so that's locked. Go back round, and I'm doing a bit arse about face here. A couple of arse fetches, like that. Arse fetches, got one arse fetch, that's known as a clovitch, that knot. There's a clovitch, so that's locked. That's locked it all in place, like that. Just wrap it round once more just to get rid of that excess rope. One half hitch, two half hitches, and let's push it down. Now I'll put the other plate in, and then that net is ready to rock and roll. Just get this wooden plate in. To keep an eye on the tide as well.
the tide on.
Let's just go and crack a tire. And on the end. This one. I've not got my waders on, I've only got my wellies on, so I'm running, so I don't get through there. There we go. It's the first end. Half itch. Done. Yep. Right, I'll just pull this one out into the... Beautiful. Numbers on this one. There you go. This is numbered up. Let's get this other one out. With it being a big tide, it comes in pretty quick now. Not left it late to come out and do them. Left it in good time. If it was blowing, more wind, the tide would come in quicker. Right, headphones off or turn it down. Tied off. Once. And twice. Number. Sorry, you're looking at my crotch again. Number. Around. Now, see there, an end cant, so I'm going to do stick it on this end first. Tail way off, we've got. I forgot to put the plate in this end. Silly me. Silly me. Right, what have we got here?
That goes under like that.
There you go. Just put the can on. Put this place in here before the tide gets it wet. You're more of a nuisance to get in then. I think it's safe to say the tide's definitely turned. Dry sand's easier to dig than wet.
Especially when you do what I'm doing anyway.
It's the suction that keeps these in the ground. These wooden plates, it's the suction that keeps them in the ground. The house bricks and stuff, they're alright, but they're just too heavy. A couple of kilos each, it all adds up to the weight. And if you dry them out, they'll last again for another day. If you don't, just leave them in your shed, they'll just start going rotten. Right, is that one? Oh. He's getting extremely close. Loads of bait worm on here. Black lug and ragworms and stuff. Get that one in before it fills up the water. Time and tide waits for no man. True, isn't it? He's not bothered about me, it's all Mother Nature. Do what she wants.